Hey everyone, Draco Magnius here for a very special video. When this goes up, January 28th, it'll be exactly 1 year that I've been doing Let's Plays, so in honor of that, I figured I'd do something a little special. I'm gonna review all of my Let's Plays I've done for this year, not in great detail, because that would take way too much time. I'm going to show you a AMV sum up of it, essentially, and at the end of this, we'll see what we're headed for in the future, I guess. First, obviously, I have to start with my first Let's Play. Legend of Zelda, The Skyward Sword. Now, being my first Let's Play, there was obviously going to be some leeway here. It's going to be a little trial and error and whatnot. There was sound issues I had to figure out and how I would separate myself from other Let's Players. But overall, I think it went pretty well, the first one. Then we went over to Final Fantasy The Crystal Chronicles Crystal Bearers. One of my favorite games, like the last one. I think it went pretty well. It would have gone better than I had hoped if it weren't for the lousy friggin' copyright things about the stupid cutscenes that Square Enix and YouTube were all on about, which pissed me off, as you can tell, because I had to cut them all up, then see if I was right with what was wrong, and then I'd have to do it all over again until I finally got the stupid video on YouTube. But anyway, let's move on. Let's play number 3, Bully, was actually very, very successful. I don't know if it's people like me or they just like the game a lot, and both of those things kind of buffed it up, but my most successful Let's Play to date is Bully, the Scholarship Edition. I did like it. It went pretty well, I think. Not that I'm surprised that it's my best, but it was a little, like, the numbers of views kind of shocked me, I guess would be the more accurate thing to say. Then we had, almost said Legend of Zelda again, and that's way wrong. Wow, even here I can't get my damn intros right. Well, it's not intros, it's me reviewing things, but get on subject. Oh, right. Anywho, next was the... No, not Legend of Zelda, stop doing that. Kingdom Hearts, which I thought went pretty well. I added a little challenge for people, reference catcher, but no one seemed to want to do that. By the way, if anyone's wondering, the prize of the Radioactive Pinky Productions Keyblade is finished. If anyone wanted to try reference catcher to get 100 points and, you know, win the prize of the Radioactive Pinky Productions Keyblade, I could show that, but I didn't bring it with me. Maybe at the end of the episode I might. Actually, I don't know if it'll fit in the camera angle, because of how... It's not massive, but with the camera angle it might not work. Whatever. Anyway. After that came The Conduit. This one I was a little bad on. I wanted to finish it within... I wanted every mission to be one episode, but you all know that didn't happen because I had to cut some. And I was kind of... what's the word I'm looking for? I didn't want to cut a lot of videos, so a lot of them turned out to be like 51 minutes. Now I realize the benefit of cutting your videos into parts when they get too friggin' massive. But whatever, live and learn. This is only my first year of Let's Plays, so still the trial and error stage. Then I tried something for October. The Oh Mama Let's Plays, October Month of Madness and Horror. Started out with Grudge, not as scary as I thought it'd be. I managed to beat it very easily. I don't know why everyone was all frightened about it. Oh, it's Grudge Girl and Toshi, and she jumps you. Ah, it's random. But it isn't random. You could figure out where they are almost every single time. I just stopped having fun, like, about... I guess the third episode was probably when I'm like, oh my god, this is just going on forever. Or not third episode, I should say the third chapter, or whatever the hell they called them in the game, I don't remember. Then came calling because, you know, Ju on the Grudge was very, very short, which I liked a great deal more, honestly. It was a better horror game. They actually kept you guessing on where they were going to scare you. There were, of course, the 1 minute long runaway from the ghost sessions, which were kind of annoying, but still, though, it was entertaining all the way through. And then there was the glitch that made me have to play the game over again that I wasn't too happy about, which annoyed the crap out of me for it being there in the first place. But it was still a good game with the one glitch and all. And then the last Let's Play of the Year was Chain of Memories. Chain of Memories went okay. I did have to cut all the random encounters out, which was a bit of a pain, but overall, I think they look pretty good, the episodes, and they ended nicely. Little surprised that we have the last few episodes and the bonus episodes of that little views, but whatever. I could go into Pokemon Colosseum because I did start that on New Year's Eve and not New Year's Day, but I'm not going to. Plus, it's still in the works, so, you know, why bother? But now, as I said in the beginning of this, you wouldn't call it an episode, would you? You'd call it just a regular video. In the beginning of this video, I said I was going to show you AMV. Well, you know, there's one person that this entire thing that I've been doing would be impossible without. I mean, you love to hate them, and some you just hate. But, you know, they're important to the games. You gotta respect the enemies. These are my favorite enemies, or at least the most memorable boss enemies, I should say, of all the games. Since Conduit doesn't have any bosses, it's just the Drudge as a whole. I thought I'd bring that up at least. Just every soldier. But anyway, without further ado, here's the enemies.
Thank you. top, so how you feeling down there? It's a cold, cruel, harsh reality. Caught, stuck here with your enemies.
gonna make it bend and break. Say a prayer, but let the good times roll. In case God doesn't show. And I want these words to make things right, but it's the wrongs that make the words come to life. But who does he think he is?
If that's the worst you got, better put your fingers back to the key.
And that does it for the AMV, obviously. I just want to take this time before... Actually, no, I'll do that at the end. Never mind. Remind me. In Way of the Future, obviously, I'm still going to do Let's Plays. And I have, I think I have a decent amount planned for this year. But also, something else I want to bring up, because I'm not going to tell you which games I'm going to Let's Play. That ruins the fun of me keeping you in the dark, obviously. But I wanted to let you guys know that, as you may or may not know, Hawk A6, who's also a member of my group Radioactive Piggy Productions, he's been taking requests all this time for games, and I figured, you know what? I think I'll start doing that. However, unlike Hawk A6, I have a few rules about requests. Though, they aren't, like, big rules. There's just little things that, you know, should be obvious, but I figured I'd put them out there so I don't have the awkward moment of turning down someone because I can't do their Let's Play physically, or I just have the horrible inclination not to. So anyway, here are my rules.
Rule number one. Please don't request a game for a console I don't have. I mean, I have a Wii, I have a PS2, I have an Xbox 360. If you request a game for a PS3, obviously I can't play it. Rule number two. Don't request handheld games. As of right now, I do not have the technology to record any handheld games. I mean, I could use emulators online, but I also don't have anything that would record on the computer, so it'd be a moot point. I mean, I might get it at some point, but as of right now, no handheld games. Rule number three. And rule number two actually leads up very well to this one. Don't request computer games. As I said, I don't have the technology to record a computer game. I might get it at some point, but as of right now, I do not have the sources to record computer games, so once again, it's a moot point. So, yeah, no computer games. At least not yet. Like number two, this could change. Rule number four, don't request any game with Katamari in the name. There's actually a story behind this. When I was a little kid, at a grocery store we used to go to, they had this PlayStation set up in one of the aisles so kids could play games while their parents shopped, right? Well, Katamari was on it one day, and I figured, why not? I'll try it. And it bored the crap out of me. If you guys don't know, Katamari is a game where you play as a little guy who pushes around a ball, picks stuff up, and tries to make a star with it. That's essentially the entire mechanic of the game, pushing crap around. Yeah, that would make a really good Let's Play. And by really good, I mean a waste of everyone's time and annoying the crap out of me and you, and it would, like I said, be a waste of everyone's time. I wouldn't be invested into it because I hate it, and it's just a stupid idea anyway. So yeah, no Katamari games, please, for my sanity and yours. What little sanity I have left. And finally, rule number five. Don't request any Final Fantasy game outside of the Crystal Chronicles. As I said in my second Let's Play of Final Fantasy Crystal Chronicles Crystal Bears, I'm not exactly a fan of the Final Fantasy series because they always change things through every different number. However, I will give you a little leeway on this one. If you can convince me that the game you're requesting is a game that might be interesting for me and the viewers, then I might look at it and give it a shot. But it's iffy. You'd have to give me a pretty good argument, in all fairness. So, yeah, no Final Fantasy games, unless you can otherwise convince me. Almost forgot about rule number six. Absolutely no Sonic games. I am not a fan of the Sonic franchise. In fact, I hate it because I feel as though Sonic has never come up with an actual original idea. Every idea they've ever had has been a ripoff of something else. In fact, the entire friggin' Sonic series is a ripoff of Dragon Ball Z, if you think about it. There's a Super Sonic form, Super Saiyan, the seven Chaos Emeralds are the seven Dragon Balls, and everything else is just ripoff after ripoff after ripoff of other games and shows, and I just don't like it. If you want to request a Sonic game, you could always ask Hake6, I think he's a fan of the Sonic franchise. But me, no, I refuse to do a Sonic game. I'm sorry, I hate them. I've never played a Sonic game, and I hate them.
Alright, and that does it for requests. I did forget to mention in the video, however, if you request a horror game, that'll be put on hold till, you know, October Month of Madness. And I have them all scheduled, my October Month of Madness ones. I don't have many, though. So I'll try to work yours in earlier or later, and I'll tell you whether or not it'll be earlier or later from the way you contacted me. Also, regular requests. When you do a request for Let's Play, I'll try to work it into the schedule I've made, and I'll let you know if it was earlier or later. If you want to contact me to request a Let's Play, you can do it through YouTube. Or you could send an email to radioactivepiggyproductions@gmail.com. But that, I think, does it for this video. There's just one last thing I need to do. Thank everyone that helped me along the way for doing Let's Plays. First, I'd like to thank the people at the Ocean County Mall's Radio Shack for helping me find the equipment I needed to actually do recordings. I'd like to thank Hake6 for coming along with me to get said recording devices. Excuse me. And let me tell you, that was an adventure. We call it Draco and Hake's not-so-excellent adventure. Just ask him. He'll tell you the same. I'd like to thank everyone from Radioactive Piggy Productions. It's been a blast doing collabs and semi-collabs. And I'd like to thank the creators of video games as a whole, not just the ones I did Let's Plays on, but all video games, because without them, Let's Plays would be impossible. You know? Draco, I believe you forgot to thank someone. Did I? Hey, by the way, hey, Watcher. Who did I forget? Oh, you're absolutely right, and I can't forget him. Hope he doesn't take offense. I'd like to thank God, because without God, the human race wouldn't be here, and without the human race and the world, there would be no Let's Plays and there'd be nothing here. No, Draco, I didn't mean God.
You didn't?
Well, then who do you mean? Oh, well, there is another two people I can thank. My mom and dad. Because without them, I wouldn't be here, you wouldn't be watching this video, and there'd be no Let's Plays from me. So, yeah, wouldn't happen. No, Draco, not your parents.
Then who the hell... Oh, wait, hold on. I think I know who you're talking about now.
I'd like to thank the lady in red. I mean, she was very, very frightening in calling, and, you know, she likes to pop up whenever I mention her name, which I did to... I think Repake 6 out, which is how it's kind of hard to read. Pretty sure he was frightened, though. No, Draco, not the bloody lady in red! Me! I was talking about me! You know, I've been with you since friggin' Bully the Scholarship Edition, and you didn't mention me at all! What the hell, man?
Relax, Watcher. I was going to thank you. I really was. I just wanted to mess with you first. You actually have been quite helpful. Whenever I haven't had anything to talk about, I've talked to you, and we've had a fun few little back and forths, even though most of them were you just bitching. And in Hake 6's The Witch's House, you creeped him the hell out, which I enjoyed, and you've also creeped out some other people, from what I've heard. So yeah, thanks, Watcher.
That's all I wanted to hear, Draco. Thank you for thanking me. I don't think I had to thank you for thanking me, but thank you.
No problem. Anyway, there's one last group of people I'd like to thank. You. The subscribers, the fans. I'd like to thank you all. You know, I love you guys. Not in the way a man loves a woman. Actually, wait. Let me redo that. Not in the way a man loves a woman. Or in some cases, a woman loves a woman and a man loves a man. But in the way friends love each other, you know? Like, you want to see your friends happy. You want to cheer them up when they're sad. You want to do anything you can to help them. And, you know, that's how I feel toward you guys. And you guys, like, fill me with this inner strength and power to do things in Let's Plays I haven't ever done before. Like, for example, in Bully, I completed all the classes, something I never have done before. Gotten all the collectibles. I got all the trophies, all of those, never done them. In Kingdom Hearts, I beat Kurt Ziza, and more impressively, Sephiroth. Finally, I beat that bastard. And in Conduit, I got all the collectibles and the secret cheat codes that I didn't know. Well, actually, that's not true. I knew about the cheat codes, I just didn't know how to get them, but I got them. Well, I did know how to get them, but I just never got them, because I couldn't. But you guys helped me get them, so thank you. And you know, that has raised my ambition in Let's Plays. I might start doing games that I've never actually completed before now as Let's Plays, because I feel like with you guys by my side, I could do it. Like, reasons I've abandoned them is like I've never been able to beat the final boss. And it's not like I rage quit, it's just I'll go, oh, I'm still angry, but oh, I'll try this later, and later never comes because I forget it exists because a new game comes out and I'm distracted by it. Or I can't beat this one boss in there that I have to get past. But I'll let you know in the Let's Play, like at the beginning, in the intro episode, if this is a game that I've never beaten before. So yeah. And also, I'd like you guys to know, though some of you I don't know your actual names, unless, you know, I know you in real life, because some of my subscribers I actually do know in real life, I do look through my subscribers every time there's a new one, and I make note of who the new subscriber is. And I don't know all your names off the top of my head, but I've made a list of everyone's names who subscribed to my channel that's going to show up at the very end of this video as, you know, a little thanks to know I know you and I appreciate you for watching my videos and subscribing. But with that, I think we're gonna end this video here. So, see you guys in the next Let's Play.
Thank you.